You're listening to the State of Love and Trust, a Pearl Jam podcast. Follow the show on social media and remember to rate, review, and subscribe to the show on your podcast platform of choice. Now, here's Jason and Paul.
Welcome, everyone, to another episode of The State of Love and Trust. It's a Pearl Jam podcast, and I'm one of your two hosts, Jason Kerepesi. And alongside me, as always, is...
Paul Ghiglieri.
Ooh, a subdued Paul.
Subdued, yeah.
You sound like a man that's been working hard.
I'm tired, my friend. But dude, I have shown up today, and I am going to do my best to bring my A game.
Well, you know what? I'm there with you, my friend, because both of the children are battling something, and it's just been a bear of a day. So I'm there with you. I've got my Peroni here, drinking an Italian beer.
Nice.
And I'm going to make my way through this thing as best we can, and as well we should, because it's a hell of an episode we got for you. We are dipping back into our series of retracking albums. Oh my Lanta! Are we excited?
Oh, always a fun exercise, Jason. Always a fun exercise. I'm sure that we lose listeners in droves every time we do this.
I would hope not. Like,
what are you guys doing to these albums?
You know, we're making them better in a way. We're also ruining them for others. I don't know. But we're going to do our best. And there's only so many albums left to do in this series. And we've chosen Backspacer today, so we are going to retrack Backspacer. Now, before we get into that, we have to acknowledge what tracks are available for this exercise. Of course, the album, duh. But what B-sides, what one-offs, what recording session demos that we've heard could be made possible? Paul, would you like to regale us with what's available?
Well, if we go to pearljamonline.it.
Speaking of our Italian friends.
Yeah, exactly. They have a great tab dedicated to Pearl Jam's recording sessions. So if we take a look at the recording sessions for Backspacer, you're going to get a lot of song names that you've never heard of before. Now, there's a very good chance that some of these songs are actually demo names of songs that ultimately ended up on the album. I don't know for sure. You got songs like Dust, Forward Thinking, In the Time of Man, Agree to Disagree, High Crime, Yonder. This is all the first session, by the way, in December of 2008. I don't know what those tracks are. I don't know if those ultimately became many of the songs that are on the album, and the titles of the tracks just shifted. It could be that those are the track listings that each band member brought to the session. Said, hey, you know, I've got this little ditty I'm playing, just, you know, calling it Forward Thinking for now. Eddie puts lyrics to it, it becomes something else. I don't know. That said, the actual songs that grew into something and became a final product that did not make it on the album include Santa Cruz, which was recorded in January of 2009. And we also got Of the Earth, which was recorded. I would have loved to hear the studio version of that. That was recorded in February of 2009. And we got Pendulum, which I suppose if you wanted to include that here, you could, in theory. The first time it was ever played was here in April of 2009 in the Backspacer sessions. That said, though, I'd be curious to hear what that version sounds like. It's possible that the finished product that we hear on Lightning Bolt sounds nothing like this demo. I mean, this could be a
considering
very
the sessions
raw workshop.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Similar to what we saw with Light Years and some other songs in the early binaural sessions, where they're almost like night and day from each other. Aside from that, though, that's all we got.
What about Turning Mist?
Is that one from there? I don't see that one in here. Turning Mist.
I thought it was a part of the sessions. I mean, it was on the same 2009 fan club single with Santa Cruz. So theoretically, would it not be a part of it or no?
Yeah, in theory, but I am not finding it. This came out, it was released in 2010.
sorry, the 2010 single.
Yeah. So the January of 09, February of 09 was the April, pardon me, was the end of that session. They stopped recording for the album. The album was released in 09, if
October, I believe.
Yeah. So they, in March of 2010, they went back in and did another version of The Earth. It sounds like that was something that they kept trying
to do. Yeah, I mean, that was around since Avocado.
Right. So Turning Mist actually shows up in between. They must have recorded that in between of of Backspacer and Lightning Bolt. That, at least that's my read on it, unless I'm missing it here.
But I'm probably not
seeing it anywhere.
So the point is there's not many to choose from beyond the album.
Right.
So we're pretty much staying within our means here. Okay. Would you like to go first? Or would you like me to go first?
I'll take a dive in, my friend.
All right, sir. Backspacer. Where are we going to start for Paul?
You know what? It's a short album. I think it's like 38 or 30, 39 minutes.
37.
So I 37. Thank you. I
had to argue against it in our episode a few months ago. So I knew that it was only 37.
Yeah.
Yep.
Well, I'm actually going to experiment quite a bit with this one. I'm going to open up with Unthought Note. We're going to just, it's kind of this foray. It's just kind of a slow burn, nice build, just dive right into the album with this this delving into the human psyche. And so it's almost like a mind trip of an album at first, right? I which, by the way, I think matches the cover in a lot of ways. So I think that, and especially with that brain image in the middle, I think it's a pretty cool opening track that I think in many ways thematically and symbolically encapsulates everything visually that we associate with the album, at least on the outset when you first open up that packaging. So now we're in this space, right? We're in this headspace, and we jump into Johnny Guitar, which I actually think the ending of Unthought Known works as a pretty decent segue into Johnny Guitar. So now that we're in this human psyche, right, we find ourselves operating from the vantage point of this man who falls in love with a woman on Johnny Watson's 1979 album cover, which I think was called What the Hell Is This, was the name of that album. So obviously, if you're listening to this podcast, you know that Johnny Guitar is about, it's a song sung from the point of view of this subject who falls in love with this woman. And he's wondering why this woman would rather be with one of Johnny's many rather than his only, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's an interesting kind of opening as a subject. So this becomes the subject of the first half of the album. So then from there, we go into Force of Nature. So this is where it's the strength of that person in this relationship, right? So he's fighting for this relationship, even though he realizes that this woman would rather be with someone else rather than him. So it's a very superficial relationship. It's one-sided. It's not very fulfilling. But the strength of what drew him or her to, him to her, pardon me, is something he can't quite seem to shake. And it's that force of nature that ultimately draws him in. So then we move into The Fixer, where he remains an eternal optimist, and he's trying to convince himself of something. And I like this play on the Fixer. I actually think that it's The Fixer in its current order, the sequencing of Backspacer, it's very one-dimensional to me. Whereas I think in placement here, it adds a nuance to it, and it makes the listener question whether or not the speaker believes all these positive messages.
Look at you being dynamic.
Yeah, I try. So for me, it made the song more interesting because it made,
I know you didn't. You've never been like super high on this song, so I'm glad you found a way to add a shine to it. Get it?
Yeah,
shine. Huh?
So what I liked here is the ability of the speaker to kind of be saying this almost as a means of convincing himself that he believes all this. And then, of course, we get Of the Earth, right? Which is a song.
Oh, you've added it. Okay.
I had to add it. I know it's a longer song. But if you look at the lyrics of the Earth, it's unique in the sense that it's about a rise and a fall, right? And they're saying something that I don't like, on the edge of the earth, on the rise and the fall. And they're coming back for more, right? here to fall. And that's essentially this awakening for him, where he realizes that this illusion of a relationship, even if it was all in his head to begin with, it's time to come back to reality. It's time to come back to Earth, as it were. And of course, what are we left with? We're left with this man still sitting at the bar after everyone has left.
There you go.
At the speed of sound, right? So if this was a beautiful piece of shiny vinyl, the first half would be Unthought Known, Johnny Guitar, Force of Nature, The Fixer of the Earth, and then Speed of Sound. It's its own little story. Its own.
I love it. Yeah.
So then you flip that record, and it's a hard dose of reality. Okay. So we begin with Gonna See My Friend. So it's a nice hard opening, which is a contrast to the way that the first half of the album, Side A, opened with Unthought Known. So Gonna See My Friend, song about going to see a friend, trying to keep that friend off of drugs. And I follow that up with Supersonic, which is a song about the love of music, right? So we have this idea of trying to, you're trying to keep your friend off drugs, and you're using music as your remedy. It's your therapeutic cure. And you're saying, look, there's so much that you, so much living, so much solace you can find through music. There's not a feeling known to man that has not been captured in some way by music. So let's take a deep dive and do some records, and let's see if we can't find a way to cope and find a way to triangulate what it is you're going through in our conversation with music. Then we get Got Some, right? So this is time we're gonna go see a drug dealer who's not gonna give us drugs for you, but rather music, right? It's a drug dealer selling a great rock song. And then we get Amongst the Waves, which is that moment where the subject is just kind of alone with his thoughts. And in this case, I interpret Amongst the Waves, I'm moving away from the ocean imagery, and I'm going more with wavelengths of song, right? Sound.
Ooh,
waves.
Look at you.
So you're amongst the waves of the sounds, right? Amongst the sound waves, as it were.
Yeah.
And then we settle nicely into Just Breathe, where you found real love, whether it's a love of self or it's a love that you, now that you're healthy again, you're ready to love another person, and you find authentic love, which is part of the dichotomy of what was inauthentic love on side A, right? So we have what not to do on side A and what to do on side
B.
Man,
I'm gonna have a terrible version compared to yours. I'll tell you what.
And well, then of course we finish with The End, which I think is a very lovely but also bittersweet reflection on human nature. And I think that, like all good things, even the best of things must come to an end, even a great relationship like this. And so we end the album here the same way we did in the original Tracking. So to reiterate, side A, which is kind of delving into that human psyche, where we inhabit the point of view of this man who falls in love with a woman on Johnny Watson's album cover, wonders why she would rather be one of Johnny's many rather than his only. It's that Force of Nature, track 3. That's what's drawing him in. That relationship is toxic, though. He tries to convince himself that everything's fine. He's an eternal optimist. He's the fixer. He can fix it. Of the Earth is that, shocking just dose of reality. It's time to come back to Earth for him. And then Speed of Sound, we're left with him alone sitting in the bar after everyone has left. And he's just kind of there, alone with those thoughts. We flip that record over. We begin with Gonna See My Friend. So completely away from delving into the psyche of this imaginary subject. We have somebody here trying to keep a friend off drugs. That friend is struggling with that. We move into Supersonic, which is about the love of music. This is the tonic. This is the remedy. Then Got Some. Let's go see somebody to help us get this remedy for you. Then Amongst the Waves is kind of settling in with the beauty of those sound waves, kind of finding your way through these trials and tribulations. And then we find real love, whether it's a love of self or a love of someone else with Just Breathe. And then we end with The End. There you go. Backspacer.
And, I thought I was going to be, I couldn't wait to do this, because I'm like, oh man, this is a really cool arc I got going on here. I can't wait to tell Paul about it. And then here you are dropping dimes. Man, oh, I'm tired. Here's a fucking A+. Damn it.
Hey, would you be happy? What if I told you that I literally put this together like 15 minutes before we recorded?
Well, I don't know that it's true, but I would believe it if it was.
Tis the truth, my friend.
Because that's the kind of person.
Time got away from me this week, and I literally, like 15 minutes before, I was like, okay, let me get, it was so short. I almost overestimated how easy it would be. And then I, for the first 5 minutes, I was like, oh my God, what have I done to myself? And then just the nut cracked. The nut cracked when I just looked at Unthought Known. I was like delving into the human psyche. Like, wait a minute. And then I started thinking about Supersonic. I started thinking about Johnny Tarr. I was like, you know what? I got something here. Now, once I put together that little story, I looked at the leftover songs and I thought, well, this really dovetails nicely. And you could really piece this together into its own little tale.
A wonderful accident.
Yes, a wonderful accident.
The busyness of your life. Well, I'm going to try and do my best here. Fucking hell. All right, here we go. I am going to start the same way the album really starts, and that's what's going to see my friend.
Okay.
Musically, I like how this one just bangs in. And for such a positive album, I like that it kind of forces you into that mood right away. I'm not sure there's another song on the record that thematically fits super well with it. So I'm going to go with the go logic on how to start an album and just, just bangs. Nice. And I love that for an album that is so concise. This one is almost a perfect microcosm of the record, and what better way to start it than with this song? So I'm gonna agree with the boys and say bang, gonna see my friend out of the gate.
Copy
I'm
that.
Going next though to Force of Nature. So early on, like you, I think it was smart to keep the energy up on the real record with Got Some, but I like Force of Nature here instead. It's not as high intensity as gonna see my friend, but I really like getting this story of love up nice and early. This song should really be front and center rather than the second to last track of the album. Not only do I think this slightly up-tempo song keeps the energy up, but it keeps the tone up as well. I really want something truly positive at the top here. There are some songs in this album, as you mentioned, that aren't as celebratory of such things, and I couldn't let them live this early on in the album. We have to stay high. So from there, I'm going to go to Just Breathe. I know it's only track 3, but this track seems destined to be amongst Force of Nature, and I love it following said track. I think there's a little trilogy of sorts.
Yeah, I see that.
With that song, this song, and the next one as well. But for the same reasons that Force of Nature is early on, so is Just Breathe. And we're already 3 songs in, but there's a lot of dynamics here. There's a lot of, this album is very concise as a whole, but these 3 songs are very different amongst them. I think that's key for an album that's so short and generally living in the same thematic ballpark. And I like the listener exposed to a variety of musical flavors early on. So we're going to go with Just Breathe at 3. 4, I'm going Amongst the Waves. I mentioned a trilogy of sorts. I think this one works perfectly with Force of Nature and Just Breathe. I believe you had Amongst the Waves leading into Just Breathe in yours, right?
In mine, I had that exact sequence. Yeah. Amongst the Waves leading into Just Breathe.
Having them side by side, we both agree. Is there anything more
important? I went Amongst the Waves and then Just Breathe.
No, I know. We had them side by side, but we just reversed the order.
Right.
I don't think there's anything more important than celebrating love and being in love. And so there's nothing more positive. And even though we'll hit on some harder truths in a little bit, I thought it was important to get the listener to this headspace out front. And this song feels like the natural reaction, maybe even an epilogue to what the subject goes through in the previous 2 songs. You got the solo, you got this final chorus and the outro. It's very, very uplifting. You feel like there's nothing you can't accomplish. The album to this point has built us up to feel, as Eddie would eventually write, invincible. And we'll need that confidence to weather some of the minor storms ahead. The first one being, of course, Johnny Guitar. Mm. So again, energy stays up, but we switch gears just a bit. Johnny Guitar is often derided as filler, maybe, or B-side level material. The more I listen to this track, the more I disagree with that. And sure, it's kind of a silly story that Ed created out of the album cover that you mentioned. But I think the feeling of why not me? Why does she like the other guy or girl? Especially when you're younger, is very, very universal. And I always say that if you want to truly appreciate the highs, you've got to completely feel the lows. Now, this isn't the lowest of lows by any means, especially in the Pearl Jam catalog, but in the context of this album, it's just one of the more challenging moments and the challenges of the heart, shall we say. So going from there, I dovetail right into Speed of Sound. I think at this point, we're ready to bring the pace down again. Another track people often either don't like or wish was the original acoustic demo. That demo is lovely, but I love what the band did with the album version. I think you and I would agree.
Yeah.
In a way, you can argue that this is a positive reaction to the song before In Johnny Guitar. And by that I mean the end of the song shifts us right out of the negative headspace. It might sound funny to say positive, but there's just a realistic realization in this song that's necessary to kind of ground the subject. So I mean it in that sense. In the big picture, it's a positive. From there, we go into Unthought Known. It's time to use that realization to build one's self back up. Feel the sky blanket you with gems and rhinestones. Just magical. It's just magical. That path is for you to walk on. I love it. Even if you don't get the girl you thought you wanted, Johnny Guitar, there is something and someone out there for you. Really inspiring song to be the best version of yourself and doing so without being a dick about it. So I like that song, Living There. And then from there...
Nice dichotomy there.
Thank you. Thank you. From there, we're going to go into Got Some. And you know what? Not everybody will feel what you feel. Not everyone will have that healthy journey along the path of love that you, the listener, have had to this point. So hell, let's help them out. What do you need to feel better? What do you need to feel like the best version of yourself? Hell, it might just be a rock song. Or it could be more. Either way, the subject herein feels so emotionally healthy that they're ready to take on others' shortcomings in that capacity. This is all helped by the energetic nature of the music. So how can you listen to this and not feel like you can take on the world? Of course you can. So with that positivity and that confidence, it's the fixer. I like Got Some into the fixer in this scenario. I agree with you on the album, for real, it doesn't hit the right way, but I think in this iteration, it does. I think these two are kind of sister songs. In this tune, we hear all the ways that the subject of the previous song can offer relief to their friends and loved ones. Again, there's a confidence and a drive to make things better here. And I can totally see why this was the lead single of the album, because it's the most in-your-face version of that message on the album. I also like how the song gives way to the next song with its fade out, and that is Supersonic. It's almost like a false ending, and we nearly end the record with the same in-your-face energy as we started it. Ed alludes to music fixing what ails you and Got Some. Well, here, it's a pure celebration of that very fact. Whatever you got, hopefully love, let's celebrate that with a fun rock and roll song. All the progress we've made in this album, this is the song to let your hair down and say, hell yeah, we made it. The problem, of course, with life is that even... if it's amazing, it will always end at some point. And sometimes too early. So, of course, we're ending with the end. It's a depressing way to end such an album of love and celebration. But it wouldn't be a Pearl Jam album if there weren't an anchor. And there's no way this song could be anywhere else on the album for me. And although it's a bummer, it's also a stark reminder to the listener that life is short and fragile, and to really be in the moment and honor the good stuff that we just spent the previous 34 minutes celebrating. It's as simple as that. Feel the highs and the lows equally. And yeah, there I am. There I am. I got Backspacer in that order. So I'll do it one more time for you. I've got Gonna See My Friend, Force of Nature, Just Breathe, Amongst the Waves, Johnny Guitar, Speed of Sound, Unthought Known, Got Some, The Fixer, Supersonic, The End. I chose all the same songs. I did not add or remove anything. Just tweaked the order a little bit. So yeah, what thoughts?
I love it, man. I thought that there's a nice narrative in there. I like the dichotomy, like I mentioned, but I thought that there's a nice, seamless connection musically. The music of each song seems to really flow in and out of each other. in ways that I think I was, you know, normally that's my preferred method to right. build. And so I went lyrically this time, which is a little
we did a reversal.
We did. Yeah. I think I did something like that for another retracking a while back, but usually that's not my preferred way to go, but it seemed to be the right path for me this time. But I like it. Again, two roads dive,
okay,
as Robert, I'm sure lost. You would say. Yeah, hey, good call, my man.
Yeah. I paid attention a couple of times in English class. All right, guys, let us know what you think about that. I'm sure you have your own thoughts. You're either yelling or praising us through that entire spiel. Comment in the section on whatever social media platform you're apt to use, and let us know your retracking for Backspacer. And we will we'll check it out and respond to you and say hello. With that, though, let's get to our lyric of the week. All right, lyric of the week time. Got to stay on brand. Got to go with Backspacer. So we're taking a shot with Got Some. All right, Paul, what do you think about this section from Got Some?
It's very frenetic, obviously. And, you know, when you anchor this song in its root, which is let's sell music, you know, again, they did this with Spin the Black Circle, right? And they got themselves in a lot of hot water at the time. I don't think it was done intentionally, mm-mm. obviously. But, you know, we were living at a time in the 90s where you write a song about vinyl and somehow it was misinterpreted as a song about heroin. I understand why at the time people could make those connections. Something similar here, right? If this song came out in, you know, 93, 94, I think the same controversy would have erupted.
I got some if you need it. I mean,
But it's so fascinating.
Almost two in the face.
It is. But what I love about this song is it's like the bastard stepchild of, Spin the Black Circle in a lot of ways. And there was absolutely like the needle moved not an ounce or an inch, pardon me. There was no controversy. I mean, this song just kind of flew under the radar. Yeah. You know what I mean? It's just interesting to see how our culture has shifted over the years. But nonetheless, you know, get it now, get it on before it's gone. Let everybody carry on. I like the urgency of these lyrics. Mm. And I think it's important because if you're really struggling with something and the mindset is music can save, then there's no time to waste. This second half here, precipitation, which side are you on? Are you on the rise? Are you falling down? I've always found the imagery fascinating. When you just think about precipitation and how it becomes, how it rises.
You have to go back to physics class in high school and be like, wait, hold on. Condensation, evaporation.
And then it begins to, as it heats, obviously, it begins to kind of run down whatever surface it's on. And I thought, but it was the precursor to that, right? It was heat that essentially causes both. And so the heat of life, obviously, is what causes us to buckle. And we have to decide whether or not we're going to rise from that heat mm-hmm. or whether or not we're going to cascade down the surface of whatever our lives are based on and just find ourselves running off the edge of it. And so I think that there's a lot more happening in these lyrics than I ever gave them credit for. I know this is not the first time that's happened on this show where we would take a deep dive into a set of lyrics and realize, man, there's a lot more under the surface here than I think I realized. Mm-hmm. That was always, by the way, a set of lyrics that I did not care for. And I think that it wasn't until I really sat down and forced myself to kind of dig a little bit with these that I started to appreciate them a little bit more. So
I'm there with you. When I was looking at, you know, what song to choose this week from the album, and we don't have many left from the album, I'm like, you know what? We're going to have to choose this song at some point. Let's just do it. And it just like Save You, for example, it forces you to take another look at a song that on the surface is like, precipitation, what side are you on? What the hell does that mean? Yeah, you know, it's about seizing the moment. It's about, you know, I think it's about seeing someone a little down and wanting to cheer them up. You know, that's the obvious part. But I think it's about reminding those around you that they have a choice. They can choose happiness. They can choose to remain in despair. As is the style with this album, it's about finding positivity amongst the negative. Ed isn't just offering up a question. He's offering a solution. I've got some, whatever you need. Some of them, like, as you mentioned, some have interpreted the song as a drug song. Yeah, I disagree, just as you do. I think it really is just Ed saying, hey, man, do you need some help? Do you need a friend? I got you. Whatever you need, I'm there for you. That's kind of what it is. Presenting the problem that you might have with the precipitation lines of what is possible. You could do this, you could do that, but I'm here to help you rise and not fall. Yeah. Let's go. No time to overthink it. Let's go, man. I'm here for you. Let's go. And so it's almost like the vibe here is so similar to Stip and My favorite lyric from Verses from Leash. I am a guide. I'm no guide, but I'm by your side. I'm right by your side. It's very much in the same world. So have a look at this song again. When my first reaction to this song that I ever got was when they played it on The Tonight Show with Conan O'Brien, which, by the way, if you guys recall, a very short-lived program, but they were on that show and they debuted Got Some. As it wasn't even the lead single, but they played it on that show. And I'm thinking to myself, whoa, this came out of nowhere, but never really gave the lyrics the necessary amount of thought.
Right.
So I would encourage all of you to go and kind of go back. You know, sometimes you can go on, you can type in, like, you know, Pearl Jam song meaning, or like you'll find a forum, you'll find, and people will be chiming in about it, and you might get something out of it, you might not. I think this is one of those songs that deserves another look.
Yeah. Well said, my friend.
Let's then move to its best live version in our live cut of the week.
Ready?
Okay, so Backspacer tour, where and when?
So we're going to San Diego on October 9th, but there's a few reasons why I find this cut interesting. Number one, in order for this to truly excel as a live version, it really does hinge on Matt Cameron. Mm-hmm. Those rolling drums, I mean, and he has to be on his A game, I think, for this song to thrive. And not that he isn't ever on his A game. At least I've never heard him, you know, stumble like this. But he shines, man. I mean, he is just a bullet train on the run in this version here. And the pacing is outstanding. They're tight. There's a lot of energy in the crowd. I like the idea that, you know, Eddie's back home in San Diego and he's selling rock. You know what I mean? He's the dealer selling rock. It's there's just a lot of
By
cool
way, symbolism rock,
behind
it. Meaning that. Rock and roll, not crack rock.
Exactly. Thank you.
For all those still thinking about drugs.
Thanks, thank you. So, you know, the setting's perfect for this song, and Matt is electric, and I think the rest of the band just kind of feeds off that energy as well. It's also, I might add, the version that was selected for Live on 10 Legs, if I'm not mistaken. So it's pretty clearly a well-regarded version of the song.
So the band agrees. Maybe a little bit.
Yeah.
Well, then let's go to San Diego on October 9th, 2009.
I got some if you need it. Turn it up, turn it up before
You know, it's funny that you mentioned the band being tight and Matt being amazing, because it's literally the first note I had. The band is super tight and Matt is like a machine on this one, is what I wrote. Incredible. Yeah. I think it's interesting too that Ed sounds out of breath for most of this, which it works. It works in tandem with the music, but also it's probably just because it's later on. It's very late in the main set. That's probably why he's doing that. But it's, you know what? Considering the theme of trying to tell everyone that you can, that you're here to help them out, I don't mind that. And I think because the music in the band is so in the pocket. And I think there was another song. What the hell was the song that we said sounded like the best version of it? Or I'm sorry. It sounded like the album as clean as the album, but elevated. Which one was that we did recently?
Oh gosh. I'd have to go back to the last couple of,
that's going to drive me crazy.
Done. Yeah, I know.
I can't recall, but the point is that you need to have at least Matt match the precision of the album. Otherwise, a song this chaotic can fall off the rails very easily, and it doesn't. So kudos to the boys. I love this track. I love this. I love seeing the guys in San Diego. If you're going on May 3rd, the start of the Gigaton tour, oh my God, it's happening. It's a week away. Or 2 weeks away, whatever the hell it is. I don't know. No, it's a week away.
Yeah. We're there, man. We're there.
So you guys are going to be out there a week from now or less if you're listening to this on a Wednesday or Thursday. All those going to San Diego, enjoy yourselves at the Viejas Arena. And yeah, hopefully, maybe they'll play this one again. I don't know.
Maybe.
Well, there you go, guys. That's the episode. Be sure to rate, review, subscribe. We have to feed the
algorithm.
There it is. And follow us on the social medias so we can medias is incorrect English, and Paul will have my ass for that, but I don't care. I'm adding the ass. I don't give a shit.
You do you.
Yeah, that's right. I'm going to my Peroni is nearly done, so I'm going to finish that up, but we will see you next week, and we've got an episode about a tour, about about set lists that we're going to do. So in honor of kicking off the tour, we'll do something in that nature. And have a lovely week. And we will see you the next time. And until we do, you've been listening to
The State of Love and Trust.